You think back to when you was a little kitty cat, a few years or so ago, and you had to go Saturday shopping with your parents for something or other. Chances are, if you wanted apples, carrots, fruit or veg, you'd have to go to greengrocers. And then if you wanted some meat, maybe a bit of fish for your favourite little kitty cat, you'd then have to go to fishmongers. And then maybe if your dad needed new shoes, you'd have to go to a men's shoe store. And then if your mum needed something, you'd, God forbid, you'd have to go to one of those ladies' clothing stores. And the whole Saturday shopping, you'd be there all day in one of these giant malls or in High Street, just going in and out of shops all bloody day. It's mental. And now, if I want to do the week shopping, everything from an apple to some zebra print underpants, I just go to Walmart. There's everything there. Walmart, Target, whatever local grocery chain you got. We got HEB. You got Tesco or something like that. It's all in one place now. And I think the high street's dying. Maybe not in my time, but certainly in my kitten's lifetime. I think the high street will just disappear completely. And if you want to do any shopping, there'll be these centralised grocery chains, or Walmarts, or Targets, and you have to go there. And I think the high street will disappear. Think about it. Malls are going now anyway. They're dying on their feet. And the only time people go to shopping malls now is special occasions, maybe. You know, Christmas or whatever. Other than that, it's not worth going there because you can get everything under one roof now. So, it's either that or Amazon. I mean, I did all my shopping for my little cat friends I do from Amazon. So much easier, so much more convenient, more choice. You're not going in that 20 different stores. It's everything's there. So, while we're on the shopping at Walmart, though, while we're on the subject of shopping at Walmart, something that really does crap in my catnip. If you're in there and you're looking at, say you're down the aisle, you're browsing your ketchup or your catsup, don't put your shopping trolley, your shopping cart, on one side of the aisle while you stand on the other bloody side of the aisle browsing for the same bottle of ketchup you've bought for the last 20 years. Just don't do it, because then I come up with my little shopping cart, and I'm only little, but I come up with my little shopping cart, and I go, oh, sorry, mind you, of course you're in my bloody way. Twonk. Get at me, I'm not I'm little, but I'm not, like, paper thin. Sorry, am I in your way? So I don't like it. Don't do that. You know, just blocking the bloody aisles all the time. Or standing there chatting to someone, and you're going opposite directions, and you're passing like ships during the day. There's a reason why ships pass each other at night. Because no one cares. Pass you in the day, you're in the bloody way. Get out of the way. That's the saying. Ships are passing the day. Get in my bloody way. So, yeah, I mean, I do my grocery shopping in like 20 minutes flat. I know exactly what I want, I know exactly where it is. Get out me bloody way. Makes you sound like a grumpy kitty, but I'm not. I've just got other things to do. I don't want to browse. Don't want to browse the ranch dressings or whatever. So that's just what's crapping in my catnip right now. I'm going outside right now. I'm going to play with a bird for a bit, I think. A lot of fledglings around this time of year, so I'm going to have fun with them.